Welcome to the 25th lecture in this lecture series introducing international investment law. In the last lecture, we introduced the umbrella clause and discussed its history. In this lecture, we will discuss the finer aspects of the umbrella clause. In the last lecture, we saw that up to 2004, the umbrella clause was used in about 40% of the BITs. Despite this, it appears that the clause received very little attention in arbitral practice up to 2003. Till then, it was understood that the purpose of the umbrella clause was to elevate violations in investment contracts between the investor and the host state to the level of violations of international law. However, SGS versus Pakistan was a decision which began the controversy surrounding this clause, although the proceedings in the arbitration were discontinued. In this case, one of the questions involved was whether violation of an agreement, that is pre-shipment investment inspection agreement between the investor and Pakistan, amounted to violation of the BIT in view of the umbrella clause. The tribunal consisted of Judge Florentino P. Feliciano, who was the president, and Mr. Andre Forrest and Mr. Christopher Thomas as arbitrators. The decision led to a lot of controversy as regards the scope of the umbrella clause. The decision is contained in the decision of the tribunal on objections to jurisdiction dated 6th August 2003. The description to this video contains a link to the decision. The umbrella clause involved in this agreement was contained in the Switzerland-Pakistan BIT of 1995, which read, "Either contracting party shall constantly guarantee the observance of commitments it has entered into with respect to the investments of the investor of the other contracting party." The tribunal held that conventional understanding of the elevation of non-treaty violations to that of treaty violations through the umbrella clause had a far-reaching effect on sovereignty, and hence the proper mode of interpretation was, when in doubt, take a restricting view. The Latin maxim on this is in dubio pars meteor est sequenda, which means in case of doubt, the milder course should be pursued. The maxim is also known through its short form in dubio meteus. The tribunal gave the following justification for this view. 1. If the conventional view is taken to its logical end, it will also cover non-contractual commitments arising under the law of the host state, including the smallest types of commitments. This would lead to a flood of claims before tribunals. 2. Conventional view would obviate the meaning of other guarantees, as even a violation of a small legal obligation would lead to a claim. 3. The location of the umbrella clause at the end of an investment treaty went against the conventional view. 4. Forum selection in investment agreements would not be binding on the investor but on the host state if the conventional view is taken. Note that the forum selection, which is referred to here, is contained in the investment agreement between the investor and the host state and not the treaty. Paras 166 to 172 of the decision on jurisdiction may be referred for these points. Now, based on these justifications, the tribunal clarified in para 173, the tribunal is not saying that states may not agree with each other in a BIT, that henceforth all breaches of each state's contracts with investors of the other state are forthwith converted into and to be treated as breaches of BIT. What the tribunal is stressing is that in this case, there is no clear and persuasive evidence that such was in fact the intention of both Switzerland and Pakistan in adopting Article 11 of the BIT. Article 11 is the umbrella clause. Based on these reasons and justifications, the tribunal concluded that it did not have jurisdiction over the claimant's claims of the breach of the agreement between the investor and Pakistan, which is a pre-shipment inspection agreement. More on this issue in the next lecture. Bye-bye and stay safe.